What's going on, guys? You already know who it is. It is your boy, TheDryerNewt here, and today we finally got Diamond AR, so I'm going to do something a little special and show you guys the best classes for all the ARs. The grind is over. Diamond AK, I went through last night and we played, and it was absolutely insane. Long stream. The FFAR was one of the worst guns to get. Those long range long shots, and it was super annoying, but we finally did it. This gun, they nerfed it to oblivion, man. But going through, starting out with the Xm4. All right, so basically what you guys are going to want to do on this is you're going to want to throw a sight on it. Okay, now the sight is personal preference. I really like this sight, or you can go down, and this is like my go-to sight. And for a quick note, all the classes, they're pretty much going to be the same. The base two attachments, like I said, you guys want to have is the SOCOM Eliminator. And for your underbarrel, you're going to want to run the Field Agent Grip. Those two are your main two attachments you want to have. And then you could build around that whatever you want. So some classes are going to have a sight. Some classes aren't going to have a sight. So I'm going to do that. The magazine, I really like to run the 40 round mag, or you can run the 50 round speed mag. The thing is, negative 25 to your ADS. So if you guys are going to run, you know, the 40 round speed mag, maybe it has a negative 20 ADS and it really is annoying. So to combat that, I would suggest putting on a handle that magnetic. Oh, wow. I can't even say the word, but basically gets rid of serpent wrap. That's what you're going to want to get rid of, that negative ADS down sight time. So this is the class setup. This is the go-to class setup right here. And with assault rifles, you really don't need to have bullet velocity, because assault rifles have a really good bullet velocity already. So this is what I kit out right here, the class setup. We're going to go over the perks real quick. Always, I run Engineer, Flat Jacket, and this is for 6v6 guys. The perk setups are a little bit different if you're playing combat arms, but I like to run the perk Greed, okay? Get you extra perks. You get two perks from each category. If you're running combat arms, you can run Gunfighter, highly useful, but I mostly play 6v6 TDM, so perk Greed is absolutely a must. And you're going to be run, you want to run Ford Intel and TAC Mask in your first perk, and then in your second perk you want to run Assassin or Scavenger. But Scavenger is a must if you decide to go on long streaks. It is an absolute must. I like to run Assassin so I can see people that are going on streaks that are killing my teammates. And then perk three is always going to be the same, Ghost and Ninja. Always, you want to have these two perks. They're a must. Okay, so this is the XM4 class setup. The AK class setup is going to be a little bit different. We're not going to put a sight on it because iron sights are really good. And like I said, we're going to go down. We're going to use the compensator, KGB Eliminator. We're going to be using that. Then we're going to go down to the underbarrel, and we're going to use the Spitzenass foregrip. And then basically, since we don't have an optic attachment, the magazine we're going to put on is a 40 round speed mag. The handle we're going to put on is the serpent wrap, okay? And then we're going to put a barrel on this because the AK actually has a slower bullet velocity. So if you want to get a lot of less hit markers and make it feel like you're actually hitting your shots, because bullet velocity is a thing in this game, I would put this on. This is the AK class setup right here. Put the diamond camo on it. And that is the AK class setup that we're going to be using. Perks staying exactly the same. Secondary is up to you. I'm currently working on launchers at the moment, so that's why I have the launcher. Next gun, the Krig. Krig is an awesome gun, man. But we're going to have to put a sight on this one because the iron sights are doo-doo. So we're going to do that. Then we're going to go, like I said, just the same perks, or not perks, but the same attachments over and over on these guns. The main thing you want is where's the handle at? Underbarrel. These two are the main things you want, okay? And then you can build around that. So for the Krig, also another thing I forgot to put on, the spotlight. You want to have the spotlight on, guys. The spotlight really helps out, especially if you're playing on mouse and keyboard and using 120 FOV, even if you're on console, 120 FOV. This really helps spotting enemies, and it is super useful. It's almost a must attachment. But since we got all that, next thing we only can have is the 40 round mag. It doesn't really reload that slow. By the time you kill all the enemies, you are gonna have time to reload. So this is super helpful. And that is the Krig class setup. Next thing we're gonna go into, the QBZ. Awesome, awesome gun, really love it. The iron sights suck. And so we're gonna put this on. And then like I said, for the muzzle, we're gonna put the SOCOM. Now you can actually switch this out for the agency suppressor. And between these two are a must, one or the other, okay? But it really hurts your bullet velocity. So if you're gonna be running this suppressor right here, you're gonna wanna put on this barrel, okay? And then you're gonna wanna put on the Agent foregrip to help us out with that horizontal recoil, and then you can build around it. So the next thing that we're only missing on this gun is the magazine. So we're gonna be putting the 40 round drum on, okay? And this is pretty much the whole class setup right here. Next thing, gotta put the diamond camo on, all right? So that is the QBZ class setup, guys. This gun absolutely shreds. I really enjoyed using this gun, going for diamond for it. So there's that. Next thing, the FFAR, man. Now this gun, we're gonna build a little differently. The iron sights, I actually do think they're pretty clean. One of the cleanest besides the AK. So basically we don't need a sight, and how we're going to treat this gun is we're going to rush with this gun, okay? This is, we're going to treat it like an SMG. So in order for that, we're going to put on the suppressor right here. And yeah, this suppressor, we're going to put this suppressor on, okay? And the barrel, we're not going to worry about the barrel because we're going to be rushing with this anyway. We're going to get up close. We're going to, you know, treat the fire rate for this gun and use it to our advantage. The body, we're going to put on the reveal, distance, spotlight, whatever, Tiger Team spotlight. Then we're going to go for underbarrel, put this on, and then it's up to you what magazine you want, okay? I personally found this magazine really helps out, but we got to mitigate the ADS time, okay? So for the handle, we got to put on the serpent wrap, okay? So this is the class setup with the FFAR. This is a rushing, running gun class setup, and you just want to not challenge people at long range for this. It, like I said, it was super hard to get those long shots just because of recoil. I suggest if you guys are going for diamond ARs, it is super easy for all the other guns, but this gun, if you're using it, or if you, maybe you already got to go pre-patch, but after they patched it or nerfed it, you are going to want to do this in hardcore or combat arms to get those long shots, okay? So these are all the classes, guys. The perks stayed the same. Secondary, I'm currently working on my launcher right here, and I'm just leveling it up right now, and then I could really focus on the attachments. So this one, I feel like it's going to be super annoying, get 3 kills without dying. But yeah, I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Always remember to stay blessed and stay humble, and I'll catch you guys in another one. Peace.